Well, traders, just a short recap of my trading session today. I'm done for the day. Here's how my account looks. As you can see here, my field orders are $1,400 loser in Amazon, FLXN still riding, a bit down, ITCI, beautiful winner, $2,400 in QGen, $780. So here, right here are my open trades. So you can see that ITCI short, I'm still short 100 shares. I do have a stop there over $34. QGen just 100 shares left, and FLXN is a bit down. Let me go quickly through these trades. So in total, I'm up like $1,800 right now. But let me just go quickly through these trades. And again, the most important thing to understand today is the fact that the market is rather slow. That's because of the holiday period. So everybody's on holiday, volume is low. We've seen the market starting with a gap up today. Let me move here to 5 minute candles. So here it is, the S&P 500. So as you can see, we moved up beautifully yesterday. Started with a big gap up today. Well, 0.3%, quite nice. And then initially came down. When we came down, I mentioned that usually when you see a big move like this, especially when there's a gap, it's usually just in order to close the gap. So we've seen the market coming down, closing the gap, and at the point where it closed the gap, and a bit more than that, it started moving higher, which was expected after six red candles and after closing the gap. Now, is this a low of the day? Possibly. We can't trust the trend of the market when the market's moving in order to close the gap. And then what comes next, we just don't know. So in fact, we traded today without really knowing market direction. This was quite expected because of the gap. A pullback was expected because of the gap, but there's no real market direction. If the market's going to move up now over this level over here, I think we could finally probably say that we're trending higher because that's the first pullback after a pullback. And then if it moves under the lows, then of course we've got ourselves a downtrend. But again, don't trust it. It's a low volume environment. It's very, very hard to trade on low volume environment. I'm glad to be up like $1,800 today, but I was the same down, even a bit more than that yesterday. So I had a losing day yesterday. Low volume again. Everybody's on a holiday. Let's take a look at the trades. I'll start with Amazon, my loser today. So I posted Amazon for long over 1896. So here's Amazon. Let me move to 1 minute candles. This could be a bit more clear. So Amazon started up the daily of Amazon. You know what? Let me look at the daily here. So the daily of Amazon is very, very strong. It just moved up over a nice resistance area and pulled back and continued moving up today. So we're seeing Amazon moving up with a beautiful upside momentum. And I guess if there was some more volume, then it could have made it. Doesn't really matter where my entry, I mean, it was 1896 right here when I thought Amazon could have a chance to move over the highs. Initially, it was in green territory, but then it spiked down, took me out here. You see, when it broke down under this level here, took me out and continued to come down. Now it's just going sideways. So again, low volume environment. That's probably the reason why Amazon did not continue today. My best trade today is ITCI, mentioned by Amir today, who spotted this one. And as you can see, ITCI just coming down beautifully. That was a beautiful trade. We took it right over here at 3460. I was the one who posted it in the room. Amir noticed it. I was the one who posted it here in the room. But the thing was, the interesting part about this one was the initial entry point, 3460. Stock came down, did not trigger, and then pulled back up. I wanted to short it here. It did not trigger. And then it pulled back up. I knew it's going to be a bit rocky. And then when it came down again, I added to my quantity. The reason why I added to my quantity, and that's a good lesson, is because it failed to move higher. So as you can see, the initial move down was beautiful. It came down with a lot of downside momentum. Did try to move up here and failed, but that's really not enough. And then when it failed once more and came down through the 3460 mark again, that was where I added up a bit more. Now, when I say added up, that was still a bit more than half size of my regular size. The reason for that is because we are trading in a low volume environment right now. So everything we're doing today should be taken very cautiously. And of course, it did very, very well. So right now it's just playing around. I have my stop over $3,434 here, just 100 shares left, but it certainly was my best trade today. We also had QGen, which was posted by Amir too, so I owe my green day to Amir today. And this one was posted over 3360 by Amir. So as you can see right over here, that was really beautiful. So again, the stock is up. QGen is up 3.6%. And if you take a look at the daily, I don't usually trade stocks like that. It's a pullback day if you look at the daily. So because it crashed down yesterday. But sometimes they just have a big pullback day, and Amir spotted this one correctly. We had a long here, initially worked out nicely. We survived this pullback because we never move out on spikes. It came down, always look for a pullback. Of course, we should have some kind of stop, especially if it came down under the lows. It did not. So it reversed again, and that was a nice winner. And the last one was FLXN. And FLXN is still riding. This one, let's take a look at 5 minute candles. So I think it's going to be a little bit more clear. Started with a big gap up today. The stock is up 13%, came down first three candles, maybe four, and then reversed. So it is uptrending. Hopefully it's going to be a winner. I did hope for a quicker move up. Right now it's just kind of slow. But again, low volume environment. It's just down a few cents right now, and hopefully it's gonna go back up again. So it is trending high right now, it looks well. The only thing I failed to mention is why we took ITCI short today. And the reason for ITCI short, let me go back there, is not only based on the intraday. We watched the intraday, we watched the downside momentum, that looked beautiful. But it all started with the daily. So if you take a look at the daily of ITCI, that stock was at $8 recently, and it spiked up to $44 or so. And it's starting to come down now. It is one way to trade this kind of stocks going up, going long, of course, extremely dangerous. But I would personally prefer going short at the time of the pullback, because when you have such a big move up, you would also have an interesting pullback. And that's the pullback we took today. And this could continue. We should have it on our chart in the next few days, and hopefully it's going to continue. So anyway, we had a great trade today. Still riding it with a stop over $34. So having a nice green day today, but again, extremely hard environment. So all the best traders. I hope to see you all here next week. Have a great holidays. We're getting into the weekend right now, so enjoy your family, enjoy the holidays, and I'll see you all next week. Thank you for participating today. If you're on YouTube, please give us a thumb up, that would help our channel. I appreciate that very much. And that's it for me, traders. Have a great weekend.
Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet trading room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its trading room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.